Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to sketch the equation of a circle. And the circle that we're given is x squared plus y squared minus 4x. So keep in mind that in order to sketch a circle, we only really need two pieces of information. One is the center point of the circle and the other is the radius. If we have the center point and we know how big the radius is, we can sketch the whole circle. So we're going to be finding those two pieces of information. And the way that we're going to do it is first by collecting all terms on one side of the equation. So we're going to subtract 4x from both sides, and we'll end up with x squared plus y squared minus 4x equals 0. Now I want to group my x terms and my y terms together, and I'm also going to add in a y term like this negative 4x term, y to the first, because we're going to need it. So this is what that's going to look like. X squared minus 4x, x terms are getting grouped together, plus y squared, and I'm going to add in now plus 0y. You really don't need to, but I think it'll make the example easier to follow. So the reason that I added in this plus 0y term is because now that we've gotten this far, we need to complete the square with both the x terms and the y terms. So if you're having trouble with completing the square, you can go look at that section on my website, but for now, we'll kind of breeze through it. So remember that to complete the square, we take the coefficient on the first degree term. So in other words, this is a second degree term because it's raised to the 2 power. This is a first degree term because x is raised to the power of 1. This is x to the 1. So we're taking the coefficient on the first degree term, and this is negative 4. We'll also take the coefficient on the first degree term in y, which is going to be 0. So let's start with x. We're going to take negative 4, and we're going to divide it by 2. That's always what we do when we complete the square. So negative 4 divided by 2 gives us a negative 2. Then we're going to take this negative 2, and we're going to square it. So in order to complete the square, divide by 2, then square your answer. So negative 2 squared gives us a 4. And 4 will be what we add to both sides of the equation to complete the square in terms of x. So now let's do the same thing for y. Again, we'll take 0 and we'll divide by 2. And of course, that's just going to give us 0. If we square this, we'll still get 0. So again, we really didn't need to, but I think it'll make it easier to follow. If you have, for example, a term, a first degree term involving y, like 3y, you'll need to follow the same process, even though our term is 0y. So now we're going to add both 4 and 0 to both sides of our equation. So we will get, and we'll keep them grouped, so we'll get x squared minus 4x, and then we said we were going to add 4 to complete the square in terms of x, so plus 4. We'll also need to add plus 4 to the right-hand side. But anyway, plus 4, and then the y terms, y squared plus 0y plus 0, and then that's going to be equal to 0, but we added 4 and 0, so we have to add 4 and add 0 to the right-hand side in order to make everything still equal. So the same terms are always going to get added to both the left-hand side and right-hand side, otherwise you're fundamentally changing the equation. So now we'll go ahead and simplify this, and let's go up here to do that. So since we completed the square, we can now factor both of our equations, so the both of our x and y terms. So for x, we're going to get x minus 2 squared. X minus 2 squared will give us x squared minus 4x plus 4, which is what we have. And then for y, it's going to be y minus 0 squared, because we have plus 0y plus 0, so y minus 0 squared. And then we'll get 4 on the right-hand side. Now, this is actually all the information that we need to find both the center and radius of the circle. So, interestingly enough, this number right here is going to give us the x-coordinate of our center point. This right here will give us the y-coordinate of our center point. And the square root of whatever we have on the right side will be our radius. So our center is going to be at the point 2, 0, and the radius, Sorry for my sloppy handwriting. But the radius is going to be the square root of 4, which is 2. We always take the square root of this right-hand side to get the radius. Keep in mind that if you had, for example, x plus 2 inside of this term right here, your x-coordinate of the center point would be a negative 2 as opposed to a positive 2, because you're always looking for this minus sign. If there's a minus sign, you can just take the number itself. If there's a plus sign, then you have to put a negative in front of your coordinate, because normally the formula just has a negative. So in our case, positive 2, 0. So now if we look at the equation or of our circle and we graph it, remember the center is 2, 0 and the radius is 2. So if we look at our circle, we can see here that the center of the circle is right here at 2, 0. This is the point 2, 0. And the radius, if we go out from here, 2 to 4, everywhere we go out from our center point is a radius of 2. This is going to be 2. So that's what the graph of this particular circle looks like at center 2, 0 and radius 2. So anyway, I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!